now to the first final of the Tokyo 2020 track program, the men's 10,000 meters. What a race to round off our second session of live athletics. 6.25 miles. Some of the all-time greats have won this title, whose name will be etched in history this evening.
And with our first Olympic final, we finally get to see all the full show that will be given to the finalists here at the Olympics.
And if it's half as good as the treat we had from World Athletics at the Doha Championships, we're in for the full whistles and bells here.
That was a light show, wasn't it?
I don't think they're competing. They've got their moment of fame in front of millions watching around the world. Here we go then. The men's 10,000 meter final. The lineup for this is so good. Klecker and Kinnaid, Fisher coming out for the United States. Aragawi, one of three brilliant Ethiopians. Kiplimo just exiting shot. Just behind Mayo, that's Joshua Cheptegei. He's the world champion and world record holder. A big field of 25, rather appropriate as it's 25 laps of the track. I think the story here perhaps, John, is Joshua Cheptegei is the reigning world champion. He's the world cross-country champion and he smashed the world record in October last year. However, he hasn't had a perfect season. If it was last year, people would put Cheptegei down as the overwhelming favourite. But does it come 12 months too late? He, 1500 metre PB at the Ugandan Champs, not his distance, but going well. Went for the world record in the 3000 and fell away and was sixth in Florence over 5000 metres, finishing way behind Jakob Ingebrigtsen. There are signs that this is not necessarily his year.
Yeah, there have been some holes in his game, as you would say, where before he was almost Teflon. He, everything that people threw at him, he was able to repel, and so strong, and that hit, we have seen that as the case with several athletes here in several different disciplines where their peak fitness was 2020, and you can try to train similarly, you can go through it, but physically everyone is a year older, body changes, and not what he was, but he only needs to be that on one night, and that could be this night.
Well, it is going to be the night for somebody. The 10,000 meters. Here is the full lineup. Aaron Kifle of Eritrea, a fantastic half marathon runner. Isaac Kimeli, the expatriated Kenyan, flying the flag for Belgium. Joshua Cheptegei, one of the key men to feature here. Yomif Kijelcha got the silver behind Cheptegei in a brilliant race in Doha, fourth name from the bottom. He's a really distinctive runner, as is Jacob Kiplimo, Cheptegei's younger compatriot who beat him to the world half marathon title and was the youngest competitor on the athletics program in Rio 5 years ago. Ronex Kipruto is on the outside. He was a late stand-in for Jeffrey Kamwaror. Kamwaror, the multiple world half and world cross-country champion, pulled out, not recovering from an injury sustained in a car crash. There's Jacob Kiplimo. Went seventh fastest in history with a great 10,000 metres in Ostrava. Reigning world half marathon champion, so he's got stamina in spades. And he looks pretty relaxed. No Ugandan male has ever won a medal in this event. Selemon Barega, silver medalist in the 5,000 metres in Doha, says he's going to step up to road work after this. 12:43, 5,000 metre runner. He's got brilliant basic speed and he won the Ethiopian trials. Aizawa, World Student Games half marathon champion a couple of years ago for Japan. What a moment for him. There'll be so many of his compatriots willing him on. Crippa, the excellent Italian, and then Yomif Kijelcha. Langat giving us a wave as well. That's Weldon Langat. But Yomif Kijelcha, twice a world indoor champion over 3,000 metres, got a silver behind Joshua Cheptegei in Doha, and he's been in brilliant form this year. Rogers Quemoy, former world junior champion, Stephen Kisa. Just the Ugandan next to Berihu Adagawi. Adagawi, world junior bronze 3 years ago. A very young, talented team from Ethiopia. Watch out as well for Mohamed Ahmed from Canada. Commonwealth silver in the 5 and the 10 behind Joshua Cheptegei. They had two classic duels on the Gold Coast. Can he find his best form when he needs it the most? He's the world record holder, the world champion. There's only one accolade missing. He's a massive, massive star in Uganda, and hundreds of thousands in villages across the country will be gathered in front of television screens, watching to see whether their hero can deliver. I mentioned Aaron Kifle, the Eritrean, 14th behind Cheptegei in the World Champs 2 years ago, but an excellent half-marathon runner. Not the perfect build-up to this quest for gold. He was absolutely phenomenal last year. Can he deliver again for a proud East African nation? The final of the men's 10,000 metres. What a race in prospect. Our first final on the track, and it could be an absolute cracker. 25 men, 25 laps. One will rise to conquer all. Stephen Kisa at the front. Weldon Langat third in the Kenyan trials. It was won in a blistering pace. It's such a shame Jeffrey Kipsang Kamworor can't be here, although Ronex Kipruto, the world record holder over 10k on the roads, is a more than worthy substitute. But Stephen Kisa has gone to the front. Run inside 59 minutes for the half marathon. I wonder if there's an element of team tactics here. Neither of the other Ugandans are interested, and no disrespect to Kisa, they are the more fancied of the trio. Kisa and Cheptegei running way off, content to be right at the back. The world record holder not interested in this pace at the moment. You can see the two Ugandans right at the back. And other than Kisa, the other 24 men, very, very steady progress down the back straight indeed.
That's a bold strategy, Cotton. As he goes out there, and the Ugandans have bookend the entire field. He's talking about tactics. It's not a tactic if no one goes with you. You're not running the legs out of anybody else to try and do that. He has just decided to go out on his own, and it is curious on this hot, hot night that we have seen take so much out of so many of the athletes in the heat of both heats of the women's 5,000. There were a lot of folks that ended up after the finish line on the track. Kisa, bold, goes through that last lap and about 66, which is sporty to say the least.
Curious in a major championship, although he is used to acting as a pacemaker for Joshua Cheptegei, but as you mentioned, the pacemaker would normally be...
take somebody with him.
Yeah, casting his eye back down the field just to see where everyone is.
Yeah, he's 50 metres in front.
2:43 for the first kilometre. So it's around about 27-minute pace at the moment. And you wouldn't necessarily expect this in sweltering humidity. I know it's getting a little cooler now that the real heat of the day has gone, but the temperature gauge in the stadium on the infield is still registering 30 degrees. This will be a punishing way to try and stay away from the rest of the field. Jacob Kiplimo in second. Joshua Cheptegei, the world record holder, fourth from the back, not interested in his countryman's burst at the front at all.
Right, and if he does this at 5,000 or 6,000 meters in, there's a decision to make for the rest of the field. Do I go with him? Do I let him go? Can I track him down? You're three laps in. There's no hurry to go and decide to do anything rash in an effort to go chase him down just yet.
Ronex Capruto in second place, having a little glance over his shoulder. And they're not interested in Stephen Keyser's move off the front. He was knocked out in the heats of the 5,000 in both London and Doha. William Kincaid, 12.58. He's got his 5,000 PB down to, so he's broken that magical 13-minute barrier. Remember when Dave Moorcroft broke the world record? 13 minutes and a few tenths of a second. It was a massive, massive barrier for the three and a bit milers. Now, of course, you've got dozens of men breaking 13 minutes, but it still means you're talking about a world-class performer. So Kincaid in that group, hoping to produce something special for the United States. And still, Keyser on his own, miles out front, but there is such a long way to go and so much talent calmly following his lead in this pack. Selemon Barega is just coming up onto the two Kenyan shoulders, and he has decided quite definitively enough's enough. And that should, John, mean that the field spreads out very, very quickly. Barega is an absolutely brilliant runner. He's so quick over the shorter stuff, and he'll fancy he can do some damage here. And the two Kenyans have decided to follow him immediately, and he's already beginning to close down on Stephen Keyser's early lead.
Cheptegei, though, continues to stay there with the back of that second pack, really. Got a few chasers, and then the peloton as you step back. He's still got 40 meters on him, but they're getting closer.
Barega and Ronex Kipruto in second and third, with a little gap back to Weldon Langer. And Ronex Kipruto is an athlete we need to watch. I mentioned at the beginning he only got his berth because Geoffrey Kipsang Kamworor had to pull out, and many people fancied that Kamworor was going to get in the mix. He has got a world championship silver medal. He's been doing brilliant stuff out on the roads, but Ronex Kipruto is a fantastic substitute to come in. Bronze medalist 2 years ago, the reigning world junior champion. And he's tracking Selemon Barega. They've got about 30 metres on the rest of the field, who are now beginning to pay attention. But that's the gap from Stephen Keyser, just at the bottom of your picture, to Barega and Kipruto. So we have Uganda 1, Ethiopia and Kenya 2 and 3. Joshua Cheptegei, the world record holder, just in the middle of that pack, coming up onto Kincaid's shoulder, the two Britons, Atkins and Scott, buried in the centre of the pack. And no move yet either from the tall figure of Yomif Kajelcha. When we get a close-up shot, if you're not familiar with him, he's very distinctive and unbelievably talented. I first saw him in the Youth Olympic Games, John, winning the 3,000 metres back in 2014, and I couldn't believe the class and composure of somebody so young. And he's gone on to do just about everything since then, and maybe the 10,000, that's Selemon Barega tracking Ronex Kipruto, maybe the 10,000 metres is Kajelcha's distance, because he's got that brilliant speed and acceleration. That's what took him to the 3,000 metre victory earlier this season in 7.26. Talking about the Ethiopian, just at the front of that group, running behind Langat, with Cheptegei now coming past him. Yomif Kejelcha is an absolutely brilliant athlete. And I spoke to a few Kenyan journalists in the media room, at distance, wearing a mask, of course, and they were saying that they were worried about Kejelcha. They felt that perhaps, if it wasn't going to be Joshua Cheptegei, that maybe Kejelcha from Ethiopia might be the man to deny the Kenyans a famous victory. We shall see.
And with that, Kiss is reeled in. Barega's there, Kipruto, and now there are three. And 25 meters separating the pack behind them, perhaps a touch more, but Kiss's break by himself, at least that nearly full straightaway lead has disappeared, but he's got a little fight, and at the front is lengthened it back out just a bit.
Watching the two other Ugandans, Joshua Cheptegei and Jacob Kiplimo, at the front of that chase group, along with Yomif Kejelcha. That's Kisa, the long-term leader, who, as John mentioned, is beginning to get reeled in here. But Kiplimo and Cheptegei are paying close attention at the front of that chase pack. We should mention again the excellent Canadian, Mohamed Ahmed, sixth in the world champs in Doha, and he's just beginning to place himself towards the front of that chasing group, and he's more than capable of getting in the mix come the business end.
He took that challenge. They came up and he's fended them off, and now Barega takes a peek behind him and sees, hey, look, everybody's coming. And the rest of that field, that pack, is all still as tightly bunched as you can be with 22 runners there.
Kiplimo and Cheptegei about to come up onto the shoulder of Barega. And I think you're right, when Barega had a little look over his shoulder halfway down that back straight, he just took his foot off the gas and thought, well, if you're coming, I may as well ease up and then gather myself for a push later on in the race.
They've gathered Kisa into a respectable distance right there. As we have 15 laps to go, they come around in 11:14, which isn't blistering pace. That's what, 28 and change, maybe.
It's far too hot and sticky for them to be interested in any kind of fast times. I think we're in for a fast close to this race, which may play into the hands of those who can accelerate very quickly, of whom Yomif Kejelcha is definitely one. Mile world record holder. He's got incredible range. It's Ahmed just with the thigh sticker 7. Isaac Kimeli in that group as well. Mentioned him a little earlier. European indoor silver medalist. Transferee from Kenya. Joined his wife in 2009. He's just in the centre of that pack, but everybody's still fairly close together. The two other Ethiopians, Adagawi and Barega, almost at the very back of the entire field. Yomif Kejelcha is tracking the third Kenyan, and it's all still looking very comfortable at the moment. You get the feeling they're just ticking these laps off, waiting to head towards the business end of this race. Uganda 1, 4 and 5, Kenya 2 and 3.
Last lap in 71, which isn't super quick, but cross that with super hot, and that'll take plenty of steam out of you as those add up through 25 laps.
There's definitely some energy conservation going on here in this epic battle. And it's easy to forget how important your tactical decisions are in a race of this nature, isn't it? We talk about the tactics being important in an 8 and 15, because a split-second mistake in an 8, for instance, and you could find yourself having to drop back to come wide on the outside. In a different way, the tactics are absolutely crucial in a race this brutal, in conditions as tough as this. Aragawi second from the back. Kisa now, at last, has been reeled in. So we've got a little glimpse of Aaron Kifle, the Eritrean, coming down the outside in their distinctive strip. What a brilliant 10,000 metre runner his predecessor Zerzane Tadese was. Fantastic world half marathon champion time and time again. Had some great duels with Kenenisa Bekele and Seleshi Sahin on the track. So the Eritrean can't be ruled out, and his proud nation will be watching and cheering at the moment. But Kisa still out front at the moment. Joshua Cheptegei tracking the two Kenyans just ahead of him, Langat and Ronex Kipruto. Jacob Kiplimo not too far behind his decorated compatriot.
And the French runner there sandwiched between the two runners from Uganda. Just finding the pace now that's comfortable. And if you're Kisa, right, if they kind of catch up with you, what was all that work over the first 2,000 meters worth?
Well, Steve Jones, the former world record holder in the marathon, set that record in Chicago. I think it lasted about 9 months. He always maintained in a distance race, if you feel good, go. Even if you end up falling short, follow your instinct. So maybe Kisa just thought, do you know what? This field is absolutely loaded. I'm going to run my own race, my own agenda, and see what happens. Well, what's happened is he's ended up leading for the first half, but the rest of the field have hung on to his coattails for an easy ride, and that is a real shame. Sam Atkin, fifth fastest Briton of all time, has dropped out. First casualty of these brutal conditions. It looks like he's limping a touch, actually. So, one DNF already.
Yeah, definitely got a hitch there as he walks off. He says, yet to give up the lead. They keep kind of coming up on his shoulder. He looks back and strides out a little bit.
We're watching the final of the men's 10,000 metres, the first track gold to be determined in Tokyo 2020. For so long, we worried about whether it could or would happen. Here we are in this magnificent stadium, and yes, we don't have a crowd, but these men will be aware from the messages of support they've received from home that millions and millions will be watching them live around the world, using them perhaps as a source of inspiration. 67 second lap, just inside 17 minutes there. And little by little, with 10 laps to go, we're beginning to see the first part of this story unfold. It's pretty much single file now in these energy-sapping conditions. For the first time in the entire race, Kisa is being challenged for the lead. All three Ugandans right up there at the front. Kisa was checking his watch there as he ran along.
Got a lot going on. Checking the watch, checking behind him, making sure knowing where everybody is. So you must have, you know, some run in you that you're able to still do that, you know, take care of some housekeeping even while you run. But the first time now as we go under 8 laps, there finally is 9 laps to go. There's finally a new leader in this thing. 16 laps in, Kisa finally gives it up.
And his name is Ronex Kipruto. And Kisa now going backwards very, very quickly. He may even drop out. It looks like he's about to stop. I'm not sure whether the cameras will show you that. It's almost as if he literally has acted like a pacemaker. And in fact, he's stopped and he's walking off the track. So, the long-term leader is gone. It's Ronex Kipruto. That's the back of Mohamed Ahmed, the Canadian running in 8th or 9th place. That's Kisa. So,
done his job, I guess, whatever that job is.
Well, I wonder whether there was some tactics in there. It's Ronex Kipruto leading. Joshua Cheptegei in 2nd place. Good running at the moment from Mohamed Amdouni, the European champion from France. He's in 3rd. Jacob Kiplimo, the other Ugandan, the world half marathon champion, is behind the Frenchman. And Yomif Kujelcha immediately behind him. You can see the tall bobbing head wearing 1867. They are single file now. And do you know what? Even though this isn't lightning fast, I think the conditions are really hurting these men. It is so humid and so sticky here. You can barely feel a breath of wind.
Yeah, it is punishing conditions. And to be still clipping them off now at a pretty consistent run of 67-67, they are making a full effort.
Ronex Kipruto from Joshua Cheptegei. Still so many men in contention. If you've ever had the privilege of going to Uganda, it is impossible to quantify the excitement that will be going on in the East African nation at the moment. For so long, the Kenyans and Ethiopians have been so dominant, no Ugandan male has ever won a medal in the men's 10,000 metres. Their talismanic figure, their icon, is Joshua Cheptegei. He's in 2nd place at the moment. Can he produce his best form of the season and take the gold? Yomif Kujelcha, though, looks really smooth in 5th place. The long, loping stride. That's Weldon Langat, one of the 3 Kenyans who's been dropped off the back. So it's Ronex Kipruto, such a brilliant 10K runner on the road. He leads from Cheptegei, the world record holder on the track, behind him. Amdouni of France in 3rd, Kiplimo 4, Cheptegei and Selemon Barega right up behind the 2 Ugandans. 6 laps to go. Kujelcha just has a little look up. Can he join the legendary list of Ethiopians to win this title? Back in his beautiful house, overlooking the city of Addis Ababa, I'm sure Haile Gebrselassie will be watching this. A magnificent victory in Atlanta and then winning one of the best distance races we've ever seen in Sydney by the width of his vest against his great friend and long-term rival Paul Turgat. And then after Haile came Kenenisa Bekele, storming to golds in 04 and 08. Kujelcha just looked like he was accidentally clipping the heels of Rogers Quemoy there, the other Kenyan, and he just held his left hand out to say, look, sorry about that.
And great history here for Ethiopia in Tokyo in 64 with Habibi Bekele winning his 2nd marathon title. Been a magical place for them.
5 laps to go.
Cheptegei looks like maybe he has decided that he will make a race of it right now. Who's coming with me? And the Canadian, Ahmed, who has dueled with him before, not afraid.
Now the race is on. Joshua Cheptegei is 4.5 laps away from the crowning moment of a glittering career. But the world record holder, the reigning world champion, the Commonwealth champion, has some of the best distance runners in the world right behind him. Mohamed Ahmed. Had some epic duels with Cheptegei on the Gold Coast. Who could ever forget them side by side down the home straight in the 5 and the 10,000 metres? Rogers Quemoy coming up on the outside, and it's really bunching now. Four laps to go and still no move. And look at the number of taps in the back. The Frenchman, Andouni, just giving Ahmed a shove, who pushes Rogers Quemoy in front of him. Nobody yet prepared to make the definitive move. Is this going to come down to a mammoth burn-up? And if it does it play into the hands of Yomif Kejelcha, who quietly and steadily has tracked the move of the leaders, the tallest figure in the race? He's in sixth place in the distinctive Ethiopian strip.
Grant Fisher there from the United States. He's still very much in the fight. Kripa, you saw him briefly get himself out there. And so there's still plenty of guys with a lot of run in them, despite the temperature, despite the effort, with three to go.
What an intriguing climax in store for this men's 10,000 metres. Less than three laps to go, and rarely in a major championship have we seen so many still in contention so close to the finish line. These conditions have been absolutely brutal. Forget the clock. This is about heart. This is about belief. It's about composure and acceleration. They've upped the pace to 64 seconds, and now they are at last beginning to separate. But what a finish to this race in prospect. So many fast finishers will fancy they can deny Cheptegei the only title missing from his collection. It's a huge group of highly decorated distance runners led by Rogers Quemoy. After almost 6 miles of running, this is coming down to an epic 800-metre dash for glory.
And Barega, who has been near the front and has been all the way near the back, and as they come around with 600 to go, he's right there in the fight. Mo Ahmed has decided he will try to push the pace now.
Ahmed leading for Canada. Selemon Barega, the brilliant 5,000-metre runner. He's in second. Cheptegei just gives him a little tap in the back. Yomif Kejelcha is like the tall shadow, tracking Joshua Cheptegei's every move. Canada from Ethiopia, from Uganda. Has Kejelcha saved his best for last? Can Joshua Cheptegei ignite the hopes and dreams of a nation? This is a moment that defines lives and careers. They take the bell in the final of the men's 10,000 metres. Selemon Barega leading from Mohamed Ahmed. What a run the Canadians having at the moment. Joshua Cheptegei just got bumped there as Jacob Kiplimo comes past him. Yomif Kejelcha in fourth. And what a run by Aragawi, the former world junior bronze medalist from 2018. What a piece of acceleration here. It's Ethiopia 1, Ethiopia 2, Uganda 3 and 4. What a race, what a finish. Selemon Barega is digging in. He's driving for the line. Has he done enough? It's a brilliant piece of acceleration. Never has a Ugandan finished on the podium, and there'll be two of them. But it's Selemon Barega who takes the Olympic title with a brilliant run. Cheptegei and Kiplimo take silver and bronze. They will be the toast of a nation, and they embrace as teammates, brothers and friends. But no one was to deny Selemon Barega a glittering triumph in brutal conditions. He joins the likes of Haile Gebrselassie, Kenan Issa-Bekele and Miroslav Yifter as a champion to rank amongst them all. Ethiopia back on top in the 10,000 metres. brilliant from Barega. Just sensational. Our first champion has been crowned here in the Olympic Stadium. A really good run in the end from Joshua Cheptegei. A fantastic finish to the race to come home ahead of Jacob Kiplimo, because it hasn't been a perfect season for Cheptegei as it was 12 months ago.
Joy in that delegation. And for Barega, what a strange race for him. He went out and tried to chase down Kessa for a time. That didn't go. Fell all the way back. I mean, all the way back in that pack. And then slowly worked his way through. And then on the backstretch, he starts the gold medal dash.
Aragawi finished fourth in that one, by the way. And what a run from Grant Fisher, coming home in fifth, ahead of the likes of Rogers Quemoy Kajelcha in the end, faded to eighth. He'll be hugely disappointed with that. I know everybody in Uganda wanted Cheptegei to win. That was a great, great effort, because he has had a difficult season. But the acceleration down the back straight from 200 to 100 left him too much to do, and Barega had enough to celebrate a fantastic moment as he came across the line. Well, if you're watching in Uganda, Oliochia, crack open a cold one and celebrate not one, but two medals in the men's 10,000 metres for the very first time.
Kiplimo smiling just as he was when this started. Relaxed, playing to the camera. And now, after a full effort of nearly 28 minutes, and there's Grant Fisher. Yeah, I came to the Olympics, didn't get on the medal stand, but I ran fifth and ran just fantastic. Ran with, well, every bit the world-class field, the world-class runner he is. Stamped himself as a top-flight talent. And Ahmed, who made the choice to go with about 300, and he falls back as far as sixth,
which is where he finished in Doha 2 years ago.
Right, but it's hard to criticize guys like that. You know the quality of those guys that you're after, and you know they're ready to go too. And sometimes you think, okay, I'm going to make my run, and the price of it might be sixth, but the price of it also might be first place. It might be that gold medal.
At this stage, you thought perhaps that Cheptegei's challenge for a medal was over. Aragawi was starting to look over his shoulder and rock and roll a fraction. Barega had the crucial gap, driving for the line. Cheptegei winning the domestic battle over his younger compatriot. What an amazing pair of careers they're forming. Barega had enough time to ease up and celebrate, to savour the moment as he crossed the finish line. He's the Olympic champion. And to follow in the footsteps of the likes of Haile Gebrselassie, Miroslav Yifta from 80, and Kenenisa Bekele, who won in 04 and 08, it will mean so much to the whole Ethiopian distance running community. And he knows the quality company he's now keeping.
When you speak to what it meant for the Ugandan runners to first off medal, but what that gold medal would mean, there's something too for adding to and being a part of that legacy in Ethiopia. I mean, there's value to that. That, as you mentioned, so the three fellas you mentioned when you get through there, and you have to, like, you now add your name to the list, because the next time that you call this race and the next Ethiopian, now you say four names.
Yeah.
And there's great value in that, that not only your legacy, but you become a part of that legacy, which is sometimes overwhelming when you look at the quality of those runners.
The face of a man realizing he has achieved sporting immortality for himself, his family, and his country. Barega, the champion. What an intriguing, unusual race. After 23 laps, it just came down to an 800 metres. I can't remember a major championship where there have been so many still in contention over 10,000 so close to the end of the race. The journey for all African distance runners was begun by Habiba Bekele, winning the marathon for Ethiopia in Rome, famously kicking off his shoes and then successfully defending his title. And there's a little corner of the stadium that's about to make quite a lot of noise because we have the medal ceremony for the 10,000 metres, and I can see a group of distinctive Ethiopian flags in this stadium. It's the rest of the Ethiopian delegation. Obviously, we have no spectators here, but it should be a great moment, as it was a great finish to an epic race over 6.25 miles.
And of course, in the long jump, you know, the coaches pass that you're allowed to have, which it places the coaches in the area of takeoff positions for the long jump pits. That's pretty full. There's, I think, one or two people have brought the coaching assistant along with them as well. But there's going to be a bit of noise over there, which is great. And I think this stadium has been really well laid out in terms of the colour of the chairs, because it does look as if it's populated. Very clever.
The medalists emerge for the presentation of the men's 10,000 metres. A fantastic race in brutal conditions. Two proud East African nations coming out in the top three. The World Athletics President, Lord Sebastian Coe, and Paul Turgat. What an absolutely superb runner in his day. Double Olympic silver, world record holder. So many epic battles with his great rival and friend Haile Gebrselassie. What an honour for these men to present the medals, and what an honour to receive them. Lord Sebastian Coe, to give him his full title. Double Olympic champion, won the 15 in Moscow and LA. Those arms outstretched and the neck straining, an iconic moment for British athletics fans. And double silver in the 800 as well. Coming home behind Steve Ovett in 80 and the brilliant Brazilian Joaquim Cruz in 1984 in LA. What a run from the youngster. Reigning world half marathon champion, Jacob Kiplimo, did his very best to take it to his compatriot and also to the might of the Ethiopians. Kiplimo rewarded with a marvellous bronze medal. There were great scenes and celebrations at the end alongside his teammate, and it's the first time in Olympic history that Ugandans have shared the podium, and it's also the first time that any Ugandan male has won a medal in this very special event over 6.25 miles. The silver medalist is the world record holder and the world champion, Joshua Cheptegei. And I'm really pleased that he's pleased, because he couldn't put a foot wrong in 2020. And in one sense, this 10,000 metre race came a year too late. But he rallied, he found the belief, he dug in and gave it absolutely everything. It's not the gold, but it's the next best thing. He is the Olympic silver medalist.
And you had surmised last night what that medal would mean to him. And you can see a smile through the mask and the touch to the heart. It means everything to that guy. And he's got world records, but now also he has an Olympic medal forever.
And you know what? I think it will take pressure away from him leading into Paris, that he can go there to France knowing he's already claimed a medal. Following in the footsteps of giants, Selemon Barega adds his name to an illustrious list of his compatriots to have conquered all in the Olympic arena over 10,000 metres. Mirat Yifta in 1980, Haile Gebrselassie in 96 and 2000, and Kenenisa Bekele in 2004 and 2008. Barega, with an explosive piece of acceleration with 300 to go, he was not to be caught, and he creates a little piece of history. He's the youngest Ethiopian male ever to become an Olympic champion. And still, just the age of 21. And he now has the pride of turning to hear the Ethiopian national anthem. Brilliant Barega is the toast of a nation tonight.
I do get to take the masks off for the pictures, for the one for posterity. And
yeah, I think they're allowed something like 45 seconds without the masks, aren't they? You've got to have the shot.
Yep.
With the medals in the mouth, you've got to.
And they raise those flags with the familiar green and yellow and red and blacks of so many African countries that tonight wave so proudly.
It was an absolutely cracking race. It was bonkers in some ways because